Hi, welcome to Virtual CB1A. This is Miss Rena, and for today's video lecture, we're going to talk about integrals. Okay, so if you still remember when we first introduced calculus, we started with a line. And then for a line, we can always look for its length using two points, and aside from that, we can also find the slope. But what if you were given with a curve? If you were given with a curve, how can you find the slope of the curve? So the limitation of our knowledge in geometry can be addressed by finding the derivative of the function that represents this graph or this curve. So we can look for f prime of x, which will give us an idea on what the slopes of the line will be tangent to our function f of x. Now, what if you were given with plane figures? So, mga regular plane figures muna tayo, mga regular na polygons. Let's start with a rectangle. If you have a rectangle, you're going to have the area, length times width. If it is given as a rectangle plotted on the Cartesian plane, you can still get its area by making use of the distances between two points. So you can look for its length using the distance between A and B, which is similar, since rectangle to, that is also similar to the distance between C and D. And for the width, you can get the distance between C and B. So distance formula lang yung kailangan natin to get the dimensions, length and width. And then the formula A is equal to length times width, you will get the area of this rectangle. Same principle lang din if you have other polygons such as triangle, and then mga trapezoid, n-gon, parallelogram, even circle. We have established formula that we can use for each of these plane figures. But what if you were given with a curve on the Cartesian plane? And then you were asked to evaluate the area bounded by this curve on the given interval A and B. So how are you going to find the area bounded by this function above, or by this curve above? So, doon naman papasok yung idea natin ng integrals. So, for the area, if you have intervals A and B, pwede tayong gumamit ng definite integrals. So, the area can be found using the integral of the function f of x with respect to x in the interval A to B, or interval AB. If you have two functions, kaya pa rin siya. Say for example, we have one parabola and then another function that looks like this. Let's name this function g of x, tapos ito naman si h of x. And then you are looking for the area bounded by g of x above and h of x below. These are the points of intersection. So this is going to serve as your A and B. How are you going to find its area? So ito, kaya siyang sagutin ni integrals. Yung mga limitations ng knowledge, yung mga hindi natin kayang sagutin using our knowledge in geometry and also analytic geometry. So start tayo dun sa types ng integrals. We have two types of integrals. Yung isa nabanggit ko na kanina, the definite integral. Sulat ko lang dito. The two types are the definite and indefinite integrals. So, si definite integral, defined yung boundaries niya. So, say for example, sulat ulit natin dito. This is our function, f of x. This is our interval, a and b. If you are looking for the area bounded by the curve above in the interval a and b, so you are actually looking for the integral of f of x with respect to x from a to b. But if your intervals a and b, yung mga boundaries mo ay hindi given, then we are going to opt with indefinite integrals. Ano naman yung ginagawa ni indefinite integral? So, si indefinite integral, same pa rin siya ng process ng pagkuha ng definite integral. Only that, we don't have a value for a and b na pwedeng i-substitute. Kasi for indefinite integral, you are looking for a generic formula that can be applied to any value where f of x, our original function, is continuous. So, basta continuous si f of x on a given interval a, b, pwede mong gamitin yung formula that you will derive from the indefinite integral. Okay? Now, let's have some examples. Dun muna tayo sa indefinite integral. Kasi sa definite integral, kumbaga, nung nagka-calculus 1 tayo, derivatives, if you remember, if we're looking for f prime of x, we are actually looking for a generic formula that can serve as your slope for the line tangent to our function f of x, pero hindi defined kung ano si x. Pero pag nag-evaluate ka na, say for example, f prime of 1, may given na value ka na ng x, then you're actually looking for the slope of the line tangent to our function at 1. Lagay natin dito yung graphical explanation. Halimbawa, ito si 1. Ito yung f of x mo. Ang function mo, f prime of x, this is going to be the slope of the line tangent to f of x at a given point x. Pero kapag ka meron ka na ditong f of 1, the tangent line, nako, kabado ako maglagay ng tangent. Baka hindi talaga siya maging tangent. Ayan, kunyari tangent siya, ayan. So, the slope of the line tangent to f of x at 1, this is going to be f prime of 1. So, pagdating naman dito sa indefinite integral, ito yung general na formula na makukuha mo. And then, kapag ka nag-evaluate ka na, may value ka na ng a at b, yun naman yung definite integrals. Okay? So, before tayo mag-definite integral, dun muna tayo sa indefinite integral. Hanap muna tayo ng mga generic formula or mag-aral muna tayo kung paano maghanap ng mga generic formulas. Generic formula for integrals. Okay. So, pag indefinite integral, we are actually just working backwards. Tandaan nyo nung kumukuha tayo ng derivative ng function. So, f of x is our original function. F prime of x is the derivative of f of x. Ngayon, pagka nag-i-integral na tayo, if you are looking for the integral of f prime of x with respect to x, you are actually going back to f of x. So, kung natatandaan nyo pa yung process natin ng pagkuha before, ng first derivative, if you have kx raised to n, the first derivative is equal to n times k x raised to n minus 1. Ano yung mga operation na ginamit natin? We subtracted 1 from the, tag mo dito, from the numerator. And then, we multiplied the exponent to our numerical coefficient k. So, dito mag-work backward tayo. Kung ang ginamit natin ay subtraction at saka multiplication, so, ano yung mga inverse nila? We have addition and division naman when it comes to integrals. Lagay ako ng isa pang page para hindi tayo nalilito. So, ito pa rin ay indefinite integral. Sabi ko kanina, i-reverse lang natin yung procedure. So, ilagay natin siyang f prime of x. This is the given function for the indefinite integral. If you were given with a function in the form x raised to n, and then you are asked to find the derivative of f of x with respect to x, then you are actually looking for the derivative of x raised to n with respect to x, or in terms of x. This is equal to x raised to n plus 1. So, kanina di ba nagsusubtract tayo ng derivative? Dito naman, magkakaroon tayo ng addition. And then, yung multiplication natin, inverse niya, division naman. Whatever it is that you have in your exponent will be your denominator. So, we have n plus 1. And of course, you have to insert the dummy variable k. Kasi, di ba kapag kumuha tayo ng derivative, if you have a constant k, pag kinuha mo yung derivative niya, nagsi-zero. If your f of x is equal to k, the derivative f prime of x is equal to 0. So, dito, hindi natin alam na baka kaya wala lang ditong x sub n plus 0 kasi hindi na natin kita kung sino si k. So, we have to assume that there exists a constant k somewhere in the original function. Okay? So, we still ina-acknowledge natin yung presence ng isang k, kaya naglalagay tayo dito ng dummy variable na k. Si k naman, pwede siya maging 0 eh. So, pwede hindi naman pala talaga siya nag-exist. Okay? I hope that was clear. Kasi, before I continue, integrals, may alias din siya, antiderivative. Sabi nga natin, nag-work backwards lang tayo. The integral of the first derivative of a given function is the original function f of x. Okay? So, i-apply natin siya dun sa ibang mga functions. Halimbawa, meron tayong square function. What is going to be the integral of x squared dx? So, using our magic formula here, short method na lang tayo, we're going to have x raised to 2, add tayo ng isa, tapos, kung ano yun nandun sa exponent niya na bago, yun din yung nasa denominator. Gawin niya natin siyang 2 plus 1, para hindi kayo nalilito. And of course, you have to assume that there exists a constant k somewhere in the original function. So, we have x cubed over 3 plus k. Alright. Now, let's go to number 2. Second example. If you have 20 x raised to 4, what is going to be the derivative of this function. So, we have 20, x raised to 4, add tayo ng isa. Kung ano man yung bago mong exponent dito, yun din yung nasa ilalim. We're going to have 20, x raised to 5, over 5, which will give you 4, x raised to 5. And of course, do not forget the possibility that there exists a constant k. Okay? Alright. So, walang sagot dun sa module nyo yung numbers 3, 4, and 5. I left it blank on purpose because you are going to be the one to solve for those values. Okay? So, before we continue, emphasize lang natin yung kanina ko pa sinasabi na magkabaligtad lang sila. So, kung ito si x sub 3 over 3 plus k, kung ito yung original na function natin, ano yung first derivative niya? Dapat maging equal dito sa x squared. Check natin. We have x raised to 3 minus 1. Tapos, ito ay imumultiply mo dun sa original na exponent 3 over 3. And of course, the first derivative of a constant function is 0. So, wala na siya. You're going to arrive with 3x squared over 3, which is equal to x squared. Ayun, naging equal siya dito. So, try natin itong isa pa. F of x is equal to 4x to the 5th power plus k. We have 20 x raised to the 4th power. And then, tanggalin na natin yung isa. K is equal to, first derivative of k is 0. So, we are going to be left with 20 x raised to 4. Okay? I hope that was clear.